Sisters and brothers of the Fifth Fleet, it's time. I'll keep my farewell brief. Never was much with words. Once you board this ship, there's no turning back. The next ground your feet will touch will be that of the new world. If any of you have lost your nerve, then step away now and let no one judge you. Very well. Then sail safe and strong, and may the Sapphire Star light your way.
Hey there, folks. This is Deckard Spade, and today I want to talk to you about one of my favorite games to date, Monster Hunter World. To me, this game is special. I play a lot of RPGs and shooters, and I've looked for action. Rarely do I find a game that combines the elements of crafting, collecting, and action in such a way that it excites me to play it every time I pick it up. Monster Hunter World was released by Capcom in a way that introduced new players to the game. It streamlined its hunts by making the materials and mechanics easier to manage. Whereas the previous games had a lot of item management, this game actually streamlined it by making items more accessible. The introduction of an auto-crafting system allowed for you to be able to make items on the fly, making it easier for you to restock and stay in the fight longer. Heck, even making a whetstone an infinite item rather than making it something you have to stack in your inventory freed up so much space. This game is a great example of how you can actually build upon your experiences as a developer and make it more fun for the player base overall. And sweet Celestia, the environments in this game are beautiful. Jungles, deserts, mountains, fighting in underground caverns and volcanoes. Not only that, but there are monsters that specifically fit these environments, and they blend in seamlessly. Combine these with a story that's simple enough for you to follow with action-packed cutscenes. I mean, it's amazing. You're not necessarily going out there to save the world, you're going to explore it. Now, I could gush about this game all day, but there are a couple of flaws I should mention. One, you're not going to be able to play this game in short sittings. Each hunt takes roughly 30 minutes to an hour. And if you're just wandering around in an expedition, well, you could be out there even longer. The game does address this with special arenas and hunts for you to be able to fight certain monsters for rewards. But some of the special arenas limit the type of equipment you can use. And the smaller arenas? Well, you're not going to get much of a break while fighting the monsters if you're in that same enclosed space. They're great for training and learning certain behaviors and patterns while fighting, but they were obviously built with multiplayer in mind. Unless you bring a couple of traps and plan ahead, you're probably not going to be able to use the Dragonator or drop boulders on a monster the way you want to. Now, I don't want to spoil all the fights, but there are some amazing monsters in here. One of the first things that you actually see is Zoramagdaros, and it's the biggest arc in that game. It is one of the biggest monsters in that game. But then the game goes and introduces not only Elder Dragon fights, but then it also gives you tempered versions of certain monsters, different colored versions of those monsters, and then they just decided, let's cross over with Final Fantasy and give you a behemoth. At present, the console games are also getting a crossover with the Witcher series. There is a plan to have this released for the PC version, but it hasn't come out yet. At any rate, this game doesn't suffer for lack of content. It just has a lot of content. And it's already a staggering amount just looking at the story and the amount of missions you can go on. I haven't even mentioned the crafting system for armor and weapons yet. Armor can be crafted at different levels, low and high tier. Your high-tier armors come from different variants of monsters after you defeat Zoramagdaros. And even after you craft it, you can still upgrade it using armor spheres. There are also additional types of armor that you can equip gems to change the way that they work. And the amount of weapons in this game are overwhelming. Swords, shields, axes, bows, lances, gun lances, sticks with bugs in them, guns with different ammunition types. And if you really want to do something unconventional, play with a hunting horn. I mean, the hunting horn sucks, but yeah, you can still have fun with it. You can always switch between any weapon you want in this game. There is no class restriction. And if you have a set group of people to hunt with, you can plan for any occasion. The only thing that's going to restrict you is your hunter rank, but once you get past the main story, it goes up exponentially. So go forth, hunt, have fun, play with friends. Do you have a favorite type of equipment and playstyle? Do you just want to share your experiences? Let me know in the comments below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and click the bell. And as always, thanks for staying a while to listen. Now if you'll excuse me, I gotta go teach Nergigante a lesson. Stupid oversized dragon thinks it can take my lunch. That was my sandwich!